Hi, my name is Stephen Fluin, and I want to give you a brief introduction to TypeScript in the context of Angular. So a lot of people think that TypeScript is a completely different language from what they're used to writing JavaScript, ES5, ES2015, ES2016, and so on. But it's not really its own language. It really is just the best of what we've got in terms of the JavaScript standards, or ECMAScript as it's called by the standards body, plus a little bit of layer on top that adds types. So let's actually take a look at what this means. So I'm going to jump into a tool called TypeScript Playground. You can search for it just by Googling TypeScript Playground. It's going to be the first result that you find. And what we're going to find on this site is that on the left here, we have you type TypeScript, and you see exactly what comes out of the compilation step on the right side when it comes to what actual ES5 that's going to be running in the browser is going to be rendered. So if I write a little bit of code, you'll probably notice something. So far, the 4 comes out exactly the same. And if I write a function here, so let's just make a subtract function. We're going to say a and b, and we're going to return a minus b. In this really simple case, everything that I just wrote comes out exactly the same, whether I write TypeScript and whether I'm rendering in JavaScript or ES5. And so if you don't want to use any of the newer features, from TypeScript's perspective, you don't really need to. Everything that you do in JavaScript is actually already valid TypeScript. And so there's two kind of really important places that we use TypeScript in Angular. The first is what we call decorators. So in Angular, you're going to see these things at component, at ng module, at input, at output. And all we really use decorators for, and all we really use TypeScript for here, is setting metadata on classes. And so this is an emerging standard that we wanted access to, and TypeScript gives us access to that. The second way that we use TypeScript is in our dependency injection. So in any class where you want to use dependency injection, we can really just refer to an item. So we want to create this object HTTP, and we're going to refer to it instead of by string, which we did in AngularJS. Those strings were kind of just living out in the global scope somewhere. We now can refer exactly to the type that's coming from the class that's directly connected to the service. So we know exactly what we're going to get based on the import that we're using. But then those are the two places we use TypeScript within Angular. If you want to write the rest of your application using ES5, you absolutely can. We're not going to force you into using any types other than those two places. But I do want to touch on very briefly some of the cool things that you can do with TypeScript. And so instead of just writing a simple function, maybe I want to write something a little bit more modern. Like I want to use an ES2015 class. And so maybe I'll make a class subtractor. And then in this class, what I'm going to do is I'm going to define a constructor. And that constructor is going to take two things. It's going to take a left and a right. What I can do is by applying a scope to these, so I can say private left and private right, TypeScript will know that it wants to create those as member properties on the instance of that object. And then I can define a method, such as execute. And what we're going to do here is when someone calls this method, I'm going to return left minus right. This dot left and this minus dot right, because we're referring to it on the local class. And what's nice is even though I haven't added any types here, TypeScript is actually smart enough to start inferring the types. And so it can give us some type completion, some type safety, as well as we can get safety from this fact that I was scoping the constructor variable. So now if I say let A equals new subtractor, I'm going to say maybe 5 minus 3. It's going to say, hey, these types match. Everything should be good. And then it won't let me actually access directly a.left. We're going to get a scoping error. So here you see an error. And then if I tried to do it, passing in a string here or something like that, if I had supplied a type here, that wouldn't match. And then I would have that really helpful type completion, type checking at compile time. So the JavaScript it writes is going to be just like the JavaScript you write by hand. But then we're able to take advantage of this very kind of intelligent type inference system that TypeScript gives us, which really makes building large applications much simpler, much easier to maintain. So that was a very brief introduction to how we use TypeScript in Angular. Thanks so much.